Recycling. We've been hearing this word quite a lot, but let's be honest, most of us have not been doing enough recycling because we have other priorities, such as school, work, or if you're really going to be honest, we're just lazy. But let me ask you, are you going to stay lazy or let these continue from affecting people's lives?
Sa mga piraso ng yero ng kanilang bubong, isinugal ng mga taong ito ang kanilang buhay habang tinatangay sila ng rumaragas ang ilog ng San Mateo. Pero paglampas sa tulay, wala na ang mga naktuntong sa bubong.
Mabilis na tumaas ang tubig na halos inabot ng 10 talampakan, walang kuryente sa Tacloban City, hindi rin gumagana ang telepono.
It may not directly affect you, but one way or another, we're experiencing its effects. Fortunately, there are people who saw the potential in plastic wastes and giving them a new and better purpose. Located in Las Piñas City, Villar Sipag Foundation has a facility dedicated to recycling plastic wastes, which turns them to school armchairs. To satisfy your curiosity, this is how the process works. At the start, workers will insert the plastic wastes into their machine, which will then crush them into smaller pieces. Next step, these smaller pieces of plastic will go to the drying area. Once they are dry, another worker feeds them into the machine, which melts them all together. The machine will then release the melted product, which will be placed into their molds. Once the mold is formed, it will then be passed on into the assembly area. Another worker will assemble and polish the parts to create the armchair. Of course, any average person doesn't have recycling machines in their homes. You can volunteer or donate your plastic wastes instead. Why not try donating or volunteering for the Pandacan Ecology Ministry?
One of our many active programs is Plastic Recovery Caravan, a program that would encourage and educate people that zero waste management is possible. And educating people to take responsibility on the trash they generate.
I think it's important to recycle plastic, especially since the Philippines is the third contributor of plastic waste in the ocean, like in the whole world. So I think that's really a problem considering that we're a small country.
The first time ko mag-volunteer for itong recovery ng plastics. Nakita ko siya online. During weekends kasi wala namang pasok sa work and mostly 8 to 5. 8 to 5 work, parang uwi ka sa bahay. Na. Parang, oo, nag-earn ka ng money for yourself. Pero yung at a certain point, hindi siya fulfilling eh. Parang gusto ko lang na maging productive yung time ko. That's why I volunteered here.
Every fourth Sunday of the month, you can volunteer at Pandacan Ecology Ministry in segregating plastics. You can also donate to them your collected plastic waste. Just make sure they are clean and gathered in one container.
Ang ginagawa namin ay eco bricks para ma-save natin yung environment natin kasi common na 'di ba nakikita natin maraming basura sa kapaligiran. Para makatulong naman tayo. Ito yung isa sa mga itinuro sa amin dito. Simple lang siya. May PET bottles kayo, kahit anong size, then stick. I-ano nyo lang siya, ilalagay nyo dito sa loob. Siksik nyo lang kasi di ba brick, matigas dapat. Kasi pwede rin siyang gamitin pang design. O halimbawa may garden kayo, pwede siyang gamiting yun na mismo yung natin, parang ikakamada natin para build up na yung sa garden. Depende na sa inyo kung anong purpose nyo, kung anong gagawin yung design dito.
This is actually my first experience to do a coastal cleanup and organize one. Actually, it's very good. I really love volunteering and doing something for the community. And this one is very easy. We have awareness. We're aware that this mangrove area is full of trash, polluted. But we really need action, so at least if you want to change something, just start with yourself and be initiative.
It is never too late to change our habits. As long as we work together, we can make this world a better place.